Hey there, it's Bruno again, and welcome to episode 2. As you can see, this is going to be entitled, Oh God, We're All About to Die. Just to catch you up, what's going on here is that Athens is attacking Larissa from just declaring war on me the last turn, and Syracuse is about to invade Apollonia, and this is all after losing my army in the Peloponnese to the Spartans. So overall, things could be going better. And as you can see here, the Athenian army has preempted me as I was recruiting reinforcements to reinforce Larissa to prevent just such a thing from happening. They apparently sensed that and decided to attack me before I could finish recruiting, so we are really in a bad spot, but we have no choice but to fight this, so at the very least, we need to cause as many casualties as possible. There's a concern here of not only quality, but also they have a lot of javelin men. My garrison starts off with a pikeman unit now, which is good. Not just a levy pikeman, an actual pike unit. Problem is they got something on the order of like 7 units of javelin men plus Tarentine cavalry, so that kind of negates the pike advantage there. I do have better cavalry advantage, but once again, Tarentine cavalry is going to end up pissing me off. The only hope I really have here is to bottleneck the streets, try to get the general's bodyguard in amongst their javelin men and wreak havoc. If we can take care of their javelin men, we may have a chance to bottle them up in the streets, and especially the pikemen and actual one unit of hoplites I have may be able to win the day, but that's kind of a far off shot. But that's all we got right now, so that's what we're going with. Let's see which way they're coming from. They should all be coming from the same direction since they're reinforcing each other, so they should be coming from the north. I didn't guarantee that they're actually going to attack from the north. Okay. AI has gotten better through subsequent patches at attacking and defending, so something I've noticed AI likes to do now is they'll split up their armies and attack from different locations instead of before where they'd all just like funnel down one street into a big blob. So what we're going to do is cry, pray, and then deploy. One thing I need to do is these guys need to stay alive as long as possible. So we're gonna have the militia take the bear brunt while keeping them reserves. The general is going to hopefully deal with some skirmishers. We do have slingers and they do not, so that somewhat will help us out in dealing with javelin, which are the primary threat. Again, the javelmen are the only real threat we face as pikemen, because nobody else can really get amongst them in the streets like this. So they'll be able to do some real havoc if we get lucky. A mob. Maybe the mob can at least tie up the javelmen for a second.
Battle group, awaiting orders!
Pikemen!
By your command.
Ready.
Alright. Pikemen, I'm not even going to bother taking out their pikes yet. So they'll be more mobile. Alright, let's see this.
If we are victorious and live, I will sacrifice to Zeus and Ares for their favor and help in our defense. But we mortals must do our parts as well. Fight with honor, and all will be well.
I don't know about the all will be well part, but we'll see. This is my opposition leader, I forget his name, who cares, he's the opposition, right? So if he dies, no big deal. Actually, the worst part about this is losing Marissa. I need it because it's where my food's at. Also, you know, I only have 2 cities, or 2 regions, so losing one of those is pretty bad too. See, they're already coming around the flanks here, so we are going to just defend this little stretch of road from both ends.
Quick march! Marching orders!
Javelin men!
No need in having skirmisher mode. We're not running anywhere.
Orders understood.
At least we're not planning on it.
At speed.
Hoplites.
Yeah, need to get over here. Here come the javelin. Oh god, I just realized this. Why are they coming? Okay, so much for my theory that they were all coming from different directions. They must have deployed opposite the direction their main army was coming. That's bad.
Militia!
Oh dear. Looks like we have no option but to get a pikeman into this. Phalanx. Get him into that. Alright, once they're all committed, my general will hopefully be able to get in amongst all these guys before everybody's dead. Their pikes, oh man, they're already getting just torn to pieces by these javelin men. I knew it.
General, for glory.
Get them amongst them. For some reason, their javelin men on the other side are hanging back. I don't even know. Oh god, it doesn't matter anyway. Get back. And get in amongst them. That's not getting in amongst them. Thank you. No. No. So much amounts of no. Get, yeah, there you go. Alright, no point in... This looks like a good job for the mob. Oh god, why are they shouting at me? They must be out of javelins. Well, blessedly, this other army is taking its sweet time getting here, so maybe we'll be able to deal with this one before they all bunch up in here. At least the javelin are inexplicably hanging back. I guess the CGI isn't completely fixed yet. Alright, javelin men. Well, they're almost not javelins anyway, so, but whatever. They're over the heads of these guys. Alright, let's get these hoplites in the action. Start warm up on those javelin men. Uh-oh, they're coming down this street. And into the pikes they run! Oh good, the general's leading the way, so maybe we'll kill him and get lucky. Hoplites are disciplined, so they don't care if the general dies, really. But the light hoplites do care. Uh-oh. My last militia just broke. Oh, General, you're in a bad way. Get out of there. Let's see how the pikemen are doing. Oh, great. Tarantine cavalry are shooting them while they're fighting the bodyguard. I need to loop around it. And the mob are about to run. No big surprise there. I could try to charge down the alleyway, but I don't think we get enough speed up to make a difference, really. You might get bogged down by spearmen, which is a bad day. Here come the javelinmen, finally. We're gonna try to get behind their main army. Nothing really can really do in that mess right there yet. parenting cavalry, please.
Hoplites! General! Quickly now!
What else they got here? Got javelin men behind them, too. Pikemen are taking casualties. Oh, hello. Well, that's gonna put a cap on this.
General!
Well, let's at least try to wipe out these skirmishers. There's nothing Rick can really do to save them. They're completely surrounded and screwed. So let's try to take out these skirmishers so I can deal with them later. That's being optimistic. Oh, cry! Did it really impress them in much? Oh man, the sheer amount of javelin fire might actually beat the cavalry. Come on, break. 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 That won't work. God, see, I already lost about half the dudes from that. The brave may actually not be as brave as they wish they were. Oh, hoplites are hanging tough. Everybody else is pretty much dying. Pikemen have done their best. Oh, great, general's dead. So, that's... must have taken a javelin to the face. Oh, God. Look at that. Well, that was an inglorious way to die. That sucked. How many kills just some of their skirmishers got? No problem. Those are the guys that wiped out the militia hoplites just like they weren't even there. Oh, I didn't even succeed in wiping out half their force. That's not good at all. Now all we got is lonely Apollonia. And it's about to be hit by Syracuse, probably. Well, that's sad he's dead. So we don't even care about the movie. But I do mourn Larissa. And all the food it provided. And the strength it's gonna give Athens. Oh, look at this. Syracuse brought more guys. Now they're not, they're just gonna sit there checking me. If I leave to go deal with Athens, they'll attack Apollonia. If I sit here, I just can't make any money. And I'll probably get besieged by a coalition of Spartans and Athenians. And maybe even the Syracusans. The irony is pretty thick, if you know anything about the Peloponnesian War. Well, I don't think we can really afford that. At least we're somewhat making money, even though we have an army of mercenaries. Yes. Also, this guy will be able to garrison Apollonia.
Ready for battle.
Alright. Let's take stock. Everything is screwed. Now that is settled, let's see what diplomacy can give us. I highly doubt they will sue for peace when
they're
winning.
You have my attention.
But we'll try.
Speak and try to
do
it well.
Money
for diplomacy
for survival.
Is always boring when
Let's
done
max
badly.
It out and see if they really don't want us to live. Sparta? You know, I released some of your troops, and I gave a gift to Egypt. And apparently you care.
Greetings
that
in the name of Hermes. Hermes. Speak. But do not deceive with tricky rhetoric, false logic, or cloying pathos.
Yeah, this is looking not good. Macedon. Maybe I can get them
may
involved
Hermes
in the war.
May Hermes bless us both
not
with
likely.
Skillful tongues that we may speak our parts well, and so reach agreement.
How much money will it take to declare war on Sparta? But at least not defensive allies anymore. They broke that somewhere along the line. about break client state status with Athens. Maybe they'll do that out of goodness of their own heart. Come on, they've been a jerk to me.
I have listened and considered. I will forbear from giving voice to more than a respectful refusal.
Well, what if you forbear? Oh, no, that's not what I want. I want you to Athens, because you're right next to them. Although, they got their hands full with the Thracians, look at this. But whatever, I don't care if they get eaten up by them, I just care if they get Larissa. Now, see, they think less of that now. Well, nope. RDI.
You help. Honor us. There is food enough for two armies awaiting us when we have talked.
See, who's the bigger threat, Athens or Sparta? Sparta. They're kind of cut off from me now, and Sparta typically won't trespass. Now, they may get military access, but we'll see. I don't think they're allied right now. See if they'll join war against Athens. And they don't think too highly about that right now. What about with money? For just proud men. No, I think they see the writing on the wall and they don't want any part of this. What about Sparta? Yeah, they consider that.
You speak well, but I fear the spirits do not approve. I cannot go against such portents.
Well, spirits are pretty wise. Really need help against Athens at this point. Because at least Sparta's down here, and they typically just fart around for a while. Athens will be a little bit more aggressive. Of course, you know, they're Syracuse, but he RDI can't really help me against Syracuse in any meaningful way. I guess, ironically, being a naval power, they probably could, but they don't have a navy that I see. They could just engage in a transport battle, and that would be hilarious. Okay, we can actually see some of Syracuse's army now. It's about what I figured. Slingers, just skirmishers and militia hoplites. So that's not a huge threat, and that's probably why they've decided not to attack. But they're still loitering, and that's just irritating. Alright, technology. Is there a atom bomb technology that we can research? No. I guess we'll go with this, because we need upkeep. See, we have no food now, so we can't upgrade even if I wanted to. So, oh, and actually we're going to have a famine when this is completed. Great. Just fabulous. So I'm going to have to cancel that, or else we'll go into a famine. That pisses me off further. Well, at least we got money in the back from that, I suppose.
We hunger for battle.
Alright, what's Sparta got down here? Sparta's amassing quite the force.
My skills are yours.
Let's check what if Athens and Sparta are rallied. They are not. Sounds good. Problem is, I could probably hire a mercenary force that could attack Larissa, but then Sparta will no doubt take advantage of that, and they'll come back up from the Peloponnese and attack me while I'm weakened. And then there, of course, is Syracuse sitting off of Apollonia, and I'm sure the second I leave, they'll attack. No good options right now. Alright, maybe the RDI will declare war on Syracuse.
We will talk.
Who knows? Maybe they'll help.
Feast until our guts rumble and our backsides
join
ache
Syracuse
from overuse.
Nope. Okay, Sparta then. Since that's the only one they seem somewhat predisposed to hate. A little bit more money, RDI.
I fear our ancestors' unhappiness if I accept.
Yeah. What if there's a little bit more cake involved? At least I have money to throw at you for this, because what's the point of saving it? We we could be dead in a turn.
The spirits would not let me rest easily if I gave.
Yeah. Alright. This is about the most we can afford to give you. For you probably to just to sit there and watch as our last city burns. Hey! Alright.
The gods will rejoice at the words we have spoken today. You honor us with these terms.
Okay. I don't really know what that gives us. We gave him military access. That doesn't really mean much. It'll help if Sparta invades us. But that doesn't seem hugely likely. But, you know, whatever. As long as they're in the war, it makes me feel somewhat better. So let's recruit what we can. More pikemen. We need some skirmishers. And is there anybody else who wants to get involved with this sinking ship? Not likely. See how Egypt feels about me. Boy, that 1,000 talent gift I gave just not been worth it. Well, it would have been if the war with Sparta went better, actually. But whatever. If butts were candies and nuts, I forget how the rest of them go. On the bright side, at least Rome hasn't gotten involved in all this mess yet. I sense aged action. Wonderful. Well, at least she used it on the guy who didn't have any army. Uh-oh. Actually, this is a good turn of events. Because them sitting off the coast really was preventing me from doing anything. So if we can take care of them, then that'll help a lot. If we can't, then we lose the game. And either way, it's a good thing, I guess. Also, since they're doing a naval invasion, they'll be spread out because they have to land all along the coast. We should be able to spread out and take care of them. I don't know why this guy is considered my primary general, but whatever. So many armies around Apollonia, it doesn't really matter. Also, we don't have to worry about cavalry since we're getting off transport ships, so they'll be just glorified peltas. Let's see what we got. There they all are. The army is mostly consistent of militia. We do have some actual hoplites in the midst of this, but mostly militia. And that's not to say militia hoplites are bad, they're actually better than light hoplites in most ways. But,
Levy pikemen!
Oh, that's my pikemen. Alright, the odds are pretty high. They're gonna land right around here. And they probably won't be able to get all 20 of their ships on that shoreline, so they'll probably skirt around and come around this way too. But that'll take time, so their entire force won't be on the beach at the same time, so we should be able to outnumber them. I could try to do some naval shenanigans, but they got how many slingers? Well, actually not that many. Do they even have any? Oh, there's one. They have one unit of slingers. I don't know if it's worth the risk. Ah, hell with it. Doesn't matter. If I lose my navy, whatever. It'll give me something to do while we're waiting for them to land. So that'll allow us to get in position while our reinforcement army is coming from the east for some reason. You know, it's sitting in the Polonia. I guess they're out on maneuvers. Alright, pikemen. We're gonna sit them right here. Phalanx. You guard their flank. Slingers. Coast.
By your
mob. Just sit on the point. Alright, what do we got here? We got... what's this? This is an assault trireme. And two raiding ships. Not exactly great for ramming, but these are transports, and transports are really bad at ramming now. Thank God that's overdue. So, we'll see what we can do. If we can sink at least some of their ships, that'll help us out on land a lot. So let's go. Listen to an inspiring speech from our admiral.
By Zeus and Ares, I swear that I will defend this place to my last breath and the last beat of my defiant heart. I expect no less of you. Make your farewells and fight!
Yeah, make your farewells, man, because a lot of men are going to die today. Hopefully not as many as I fear. Our cavalry's going to have a field day on with their landing, so that's good. Only thing is, we got to delay their landing for time for our guys to get there and not be exhausted.
Quarantine cavalry! Swift melee cavalry! Syracusan cavalry!
Oh. Alright, we're going to do some naval shenanigans here. They are not going to land with this marauding out here. These Tarantine cavalry and javelin men are going to be an issue. We're going to try to split them up so we can ram them. I'm going to use the raiding ships as bait. Have the trireme sit back here waiting to ram somebody. Now, if I can get one good ram with double time and it doesn't bug out and the ship just inexplicably stops, then we should be able to one-shot one of these transports. Cavalry up here. We're gonna need them.
Set oars! Moving out! General!
No, don't come after the trireme, guys. He's just sitting here observing. I don't think they're buying it. These guys chasing them, hoplites, I don't care about that, they won't be able to catch them. We gotta get rid of these Tarantine cavalry. Not because they have cavalry, because they can throw javelins at my men. Primarily my ships. No, bad idea, bad idea. Turn around. Uh-oh. Going for the ram. Go fast. Going for the ram. Yes, knocked out that ship. Get out of there. Yeah, that's two ships down. Alright, move out, move out. Get them all lined up and hit them again. Yeah, he didn't have enough speed to hit, take out that ship, but this guy will. Just don't cut across from each other. And swing around. Uh-oh, he's turning. That's very awkward. Oh, he's gonna ram my own ship. Well, he got it. That was his world's slowest ram. Get out, get out, get out. Uh-oh. Oh, there, that guy's finished.
Ship's ready! To the oars!
Okay, they're getting strung out now. We can take up this ship. Turn into it. There you go. Hit him. Hit him. Yeah. Damn it. What? What are they, Romans, and they got a stupid Corvus that just yanked onto them? Okay, well, we gotta save that ship. Ram. Alright, that should unlatch them if they don't get nailed by javelins. Although they're probably gonna piss themselves now. We because yeah, there they go. All right, well, we did what we could. They sank 3 or 4 ships. I lost count. And I lost 2 light ships that were garrison units anyway. Not too bad. Let's get an admiral on the shore. And army's gonna have to start moving a little faster. Hustle up, man. At least my cavalry's here. They're a little worn out, but they'll get fresh.
Advance at speed. Tarantine cavalry.
All right, at least we have Tarantine cavalry to help contest the landing. And these guys didn't—they only took 5 casualties with the Thurio spears. Well, not a bad start to the battle. I would have preferred to sink more ships, but 3 against 20. Even if they're transports, the odds still not high. At least they didn't have many slingers. That would have just completely ruined me right off the bat. Slingers on transports are the god weapon until artillery at sea for some reason.
All men ashore!
Keep on hustling. These guys are going to be exhausted by the time they get to the battle. Let's see where they're gonna land at. Now that we chased them all over the way over here, they may just decide to land along all this beachhead, which means we'll have to shift it. But considering that they can't land right here, and if they start to land on this peninsula, that'll split their army, which is good for us. Let's get these Thurios over here. Levies, you're supposed to be running, you lazy bastards. Well, looks like they're gonna split land along this peninsula and this beach right here. So we need to contest that with further javelin men. Maybe a little bit of javelin men there. Slingers there. Uplights, javelin. We're gonna send our cavalry over there. And stewed. Hopefully our reinforcements will be here soon. No, probably not. Get our citizen cavalry prepared. See who's landing here. Militia, Tarantine cavalry, slingers. Oh, hero, their king.
At your service. Quickly now. Pikemen!
Well, since their king's over here, I can harass this beach for a while, but we're gonna put everything we got in dealing with hero here.
Quick march!
Have the citizen cavalry and slingers just string this flank along. Once those slingers dismount and just charge them with the Tarantine cavalry. You might want backup though. Alright, go! They're giving supporting fire. Look at that, slingers. Not killing them as fast as I had hoped. Really doing quite poorly at killing them, men. Get out of there.
General! Pike infantry and your canteen cavalry! Militia! Double time!
Where's my pikemen over here? They're probably sucking wind, yeah. Alright, I guess I can walk now. We really. It'll be no good if they show up vomiting. Oh, where's this guy going?
Heavy pikeman.
I guess we can send a pike unit to deal with him. Trying to be sneaky.
Canteen cavalry!
You guys need to get over here. Alright, they're already firing on that landing force. We're gonna have to probably defend this spot right here with these pikemen. Lyrians. What kind of atrocity is going on here? Oh, my Tarantines are out of javelins. Alright, well, charge into that because we need that pike unit freed up.
General!
They're actually providing. I don't think that's their intention, but they're providing fire support to their landing crew. I hate it. Going on over here. 13 cavalry gonna get killed by cavalry. The irony's pretty thick there. Oh look, all their slingers landed on this one side. How convenient! Keep them on skirmish mode. They'll string those guys along. And I don't want to move these pikemen any further up because he's this fire support crap going on here. I guess that's what it is. The world will say that's what it is. Give the AI the benefit of the doubt. They probably don't deserve it. Alright, man, you gotta hustle up. We need to get phalanx up here before they come there into the town square. Alright. Citizen cavalry doing a pretty good job. Oh, crap. We don't want to. Oh, this is our king too. We don't want him dead. Get out of there. Chase those guys that are broken. Man, guys do not shatter like they used to. Alright, we gotta get out of here. Just start throwing rocks at him in the rear. What's going on over here? Alright, we won this, and there's Hero, just being a hero. Oh, they finally decided to land. I guess they were providing missile support on purpose. We'll continue to pretend that that's what was going on. They're looping around it. They don't want any part of this. So, we too will loop back around it. Because we have an eye in the sky. Out your pikes. Now these are mercenaries. I don't really care if they die because I can't really afford to keep financing them. I just probably got them to stop this army. Alright, let's get these pikes into action. Finish up that Tarantine cavalry unit. It's lacking in cavalry. Slingers keep chasing them. Where are they? I don't even know where they're going. They're still chasing my cavalry, I guess. Okay, that's fine by me. Here comes Hero. No, militia hoplites that landed. Need to get these Tarantine dealt with. They're hanging tough against Tarantine cavalry that are actually mounted. Okay, that's just strange. Slingers are pissing me off. Overall, this is going not bad. The bulk of the casualties have been mercenaries, so I can deal with that.
Pikemen!
Keep advancing, pikemen. I don't care. I know those militia hoplites are scary in the flanks. Look at these guys. Dismounted, they are just beastly. They're like miniature thorax swordsmen, apparently.
General!
What's going on over here? Oh, they finally got wise to me throwing rocks at them, but good old skirmish mode. Watch out for those guys. Let's link up with these guys and deal with this crap. Actually, go down that street. Come up behind him. Alright, we got hero engaged here. What was this? Oh, javelin man. Oh, right next to my cavalry again. They're really good at this. Uh-oh. See, this is what happens when you rely on skirmish mode. And these Tarentine cavalry that are dismounted are still hanging in against two units of Tarentine cavalry and Thurio's spears. I want to be them when I grow up. I get sorted in that street since they finally decided to stop chasing after my cavalry. But are still chasing it. Oh, no, not entirely. Alright, where's let's get these guys on him. Let's go meet and greet these javelin men. Alright, Illyrian levies are shooting my pike men in the back. Let's not get that. Move these guys to go deal with this hoplite unit over here.
Syracusan cavalry! They will be forward!
Now, Hero's not being all that heroic, he's running away. Unfortunately, he's on a peninsula and they do not know the art of remounting on boats. Where are they going? And where did these guys come from? I guess these guys must have rallied from earlier. I'm getting tired of your athletic shenanigans here. Just keep floating around. Hero is heroically watching his army die. Well, not really. He's got he can't even be bothered to look at it. See, there he is, sucking wind. I can't even look at him. These aren't the men I knew. Oh wait, no, we don't want to do that. Let's just keep moving.
Quickly now! Levy pikemen! Orders understood.
We're going to flank with put that unit with pikemen, hilariously.
Levy pikemen!
Oh, we finally caught up with these guys. And who else is still jerking around here? Are they finally shattered? Alright. This is our pike garrison unit, so we don't have to worry much about them. Oh, these are the club levies. I thought these were actually useful levies. I forgot about this. Hey, these are the guys that were going to turn the tide. Maybe they actually did. No, not really, but whatever. They helped. Get them back to the square just to cover. I think they know all is lost. Well, let's make sure that's what really is true. There they all go. Oh, look at this. You know what? Just let them throw javelins at them. We don't even want to bother. Yes, retreat right into the pikes, men. Oh, what a terrible thing. Oh, these guys did not break after all. Okay. Well, we can fix that. I think he's still alive. It's hard to tell since he wasn't the actual leader. That should do it. Or not. Who's still hanging in? There we go. Alright, well at least we dealt with the Syracusan invasion. And most of our casualties were either garrison units or mercenaries, so not bad. It'll take them a while to muster another army, and that's assuming they don't get war with Carthage, which they surprisingly don't seem to be in one yet. Of course, we have no reason to celebrate. It just delays our misery. Pity that the kills shown in experience accrued doesn't count ramming ships. Because apparently when you ram a ship, all hands are lost, always, because nobody knows how to swim, and they're all wearing armor that sinks them straight to the bottom, apparently. I think I'm going to be merciful because maybe, just maybe, they will sue for peace. See, Syracuse got another army, but not much of one. I'd be surprised if they sent another one after me after that disaster. Oh, well, so much for him. We're running through kings like nobody's business now. Let's see, who's in my family? Let's see, what are you? Yeah, we'll go with you. We'll keep up the trend of heroic men on horseback dying gloriously for our family. What is your name? Is that Belisleos? Let's see what happens. Offspring stallions, some of the most impressive animals. Local legend. Yay! More public order so we can tax them further. Pipeline finished because we lived. Really? He was so idle for that one turn. Fighting a battle. Okay. Yeah, you don't have to worry about assassinations much on the ocean. And as a naval unit, typically the best thing to do is get the replenishment rate and ammo. Well,
it is an honor to serve.
Here's what's left of their army. I doubt he can take it by himself. Oh, well, definitely not with that army there. Actually, that's probably actually a navy. Well, whatever. He didn't even show up. I guess there's a limit to how many armies you can have show up. Oh, wait, no, he had an agent action on him. That's right, that's probably what kept him from showing up. Okay. Alright, well, we have a little bit of breathing room now. See if Syracuse will sue for peace.
Greetings! Well, do not stand there mute as though with the tongue cut from your head.
They will not.
Speak!
Well, whatever. Well, RDI has joined us in our war against Sparta.
You honor us! There's food enough for two armies awaiting us when we have talked.
Both in same proximity. I don't know how much money. No, they really don't want any of that. Okay. Actually, we can set a Can't we set a war target? We have to be allied? We probably do have to be allied. Let's see, maybe defensive alliance.
We have need of talk, I'm sure. But we also need good food, a warm fire.
They still don't feel too good about that. We do have military.
There's a good pork roasting for you.
If Sparta shows up, maybe they'll help us out. So they got nothing else going on right now. And we hope that stays the case. Because anybody that declares war on them isn't going to think too highly of me. Which is par for the course at the moment. Alright, now we're getting something approaching a decent army. I want some more of these. We don't want any more of those club levies. They're okay as a garrison unit here, actually. In fact, we're going to have him take over garrison duty. Take this guy. And now we'll get some extra Illyrians. Nope. Oh, for God's sake. Wrong button. Okay. Okay. We don't need injured mercenaries, and we need money more. Actually, we need a lot of money. Just hang on to one cavalry unit in case something terrible happens.
Police reporting.
Two crew fleet? No. Don't think so. Actually, let's get a champion. He can help us out. Which champion we got here? I love military training as the first champion. They'll slowly accrue experience, and experience units are pretty amazing. And you don't have to worry about a lot of the actions later. Also, if he follows the army, you can use him offensively. Oh, and I also had it. I forgot I also had a quest to do that.
I am greater than mighty Achilles.
Okay, so we'll use him to train up our army, and we can use him offensively with our army as we move back to hopefully take back Thessaly, which is Larissa. That Spartan army is getting pretty horrifically big. But we need to spy on Thessaly.
Is there nothing else?
See, we're going to need a lot of cavalry. Their army is not nearly as scary as Sparta's, because, I mean, they mostly got militia and just a few hoplites, mostly javelin men, mercenaries. Sparta has, you know, see, Periokis, and we saw before how awesome those guys are. Friggin' Periokis pikemen. So, we'll try to take out the Athenians first and deal with the Spartans whenever that comes up. Oh, what is this? They've got cavalry now? Frightening. Really need to declare peace with them, but they just aren't having it. Let's try.
You have my attention. Speak, and try to do it well, for diplomacy is always boring when done badly.
Well, they wouldn't... Yeah, they wouldn't accept peace. I just got... Already had to declare war on him, so whatever. Alright, well, we seem to have somewhat survived this encounter of everybody is just dogpiling on me. I mean, things are looking better than they were when this started out. I mean, yeah, we lost Thessaly, but that was kind of a foregone conclusion. But main things, we stopped the Syracusan invasion, and now we're building up an army that hopefully can deal with the Athenian army, which is not all that impressive. So, that'll end. We will end episode 2 on a message of hope. It's a faint glimmer of hope, but hey, we're still alive. So that will be the next episode entitled, We're Still Alive. Until next time.